When Neil was about 7 years old, a rabbit he especially liked escaped from its cage. He relates, "I looked all over our little farm, but I could not find it anywhere. I remember walking back behind an old barn and praying that I could find the rabbit. Immediately after the prayer, an image came into my mind of a spot beneath some boards. And sure enough, I went to that spot and found my rabbit. This experience and many others like it taught me that the Lord responds to the small and simple prayers of all of us."
Elder Anderson recalls, "I remember praying in my mind that I would say the words that needed to be spoken. What followed was a little miracle for me. I told them more than I knew. I felt the power of the Lord as He guided me through sensitive explanations and the sharing of my deep convictions. I could feel the Spirit of the Lord as I spoke. At the conclusion, they expressed their appreciation and quietly acknowledged their respect for what I believed. I learned that there is a power and influence in this sacred work beyond ourselves, and that it is worth defending."
In 1990, I was called to serve in the recently created France-Bordeaux mission. It was being presided over at the time by Neil L. Anderson. I still remember seeing him for the first time while waiting for my baggage at the Bordeaux airport. He was there on the other side of a glass wall waiting for me to finish. And little did I know at that time that he would later become an apostle. I had several opportunities over the next year of my mission to meet with then President Anderson and get to know and grow to love his family. One of my first official meetings with him came my second day in the mission field. He invited me into his office, closed the door, and asked me to put my foot on a stool. He then proceeded to take out a brush and jar of shoe polish and began to polish my shoes. His actions had the desired effect. At that moment, I had an inkling of what it must have been like for the disciples to have their feet washed by the Savior. I wasn't worthy to have my shoes polished by this man, and yet there he was serving me by emulating the Savior's washing of the feet. I'll never forget that example, and now that he's an apostle, it means even more to me. Shortly after my mission, I got married and told my wife that I believed Neil L. Anderson would someday become an apostle. When that day arrived, I wasn't surprised. He was a man full of faith and love for the Lord, with a willingness to give all that he has to building up the kingdom of God. I saw the evidence of his faith several times while on my mission, when the number of convert baptisms skyrocketed to unheard of rates for France. Sure, it required faith, sacrifice, and obedience by the missionaries, but President Anderson's motivating leadership, vision, and willingness to follow the Spirit made all the difference. He was very serious about keeping commitments made with priesthood leaders, and once chided me for not keeping my own commitment to him. While it was a serious and stern rebuke, I could tell he was trying to teach me an important lesson, and did so out of love. He taught me a principle I'll never forget. I know Elder Anderson is called of God to be an apostle and special witness of Christ. He'll always be one of the greatest influences in my life of righteous living and loving leadership.
Spiritual journey is the process of a lifetime. We do not know everything in the beginning or even along the way. We first build a foundation of faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. We treasure the principles and ordinances of repentance, baptism, and receiving the Holy Ghost. We include a continuing commitment to prayer, a willingness to be obedient, and an ongoing witness of the Book of Mormon. We then remain steady and patient as we progress through mortality. At time, the Lord's answer will be, "You don't know everything, but you know enough. Enough to keep the commandments and to do what is right." Challenges, difficulties, questions, doubts, these are part of our mortality. But we are not alone. We have enormous spiritual reservoirs of light and truth available to us. Our questions and doubts are resolved or become less concerning to us. Our faith becomes simple and pure. We come to know what we already knew. You don't know everything, but you know enough. Jesus said, "Except ye become as little children, ye shall not enter the kingdom of heaven." Jesus is the Christ. He is resurrected. He is our Savior and Redeemer. Through the prophet Joseph Smith, his priesthood was restored upon the earth. You don't know everything, but you know enough. I so testify in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you. There will always be something you leave behind when you respond to the prophet's call to serve. In 1961, at age 18 and holding the Aaronic priesthood, Sidney Going was becoming a star in New Zealand rugby. Because of his remarkable abilities, many thought he would be chosen the very next year for the national All Blacks rugby team. At age 19, in this critical moment of his ascending rugby career, Sid declared that he would forego rugby to serve a mission. Some called him crazy, others called him foolish. They protested that his opportunity in rugby might never come again. 48 years ago this month, 19-year-old Sidney Going left New Zealand to serve as a missionary for the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. It was evening, and he and his companion were just about to return to their apartment. They decided to visit one more family. The father let them in. Elder Going and his companion testified of the Savior. The family accepted a Book of Mormon. The father read all night. In the next week and a half, he read the entire Book of Mormon, the Doctrine and Covenants, and the Pearl of Great Price. A few weeks later, the family was baptized. After his mission, Sid Going became one of the greatest halfbacks in All Blacks history.
Looking for the cut. Sid Going, how did that happen?
How good was Sid Going? He was so good that training and game schedules were changed because he would not play on Sunday. Sid was so good, the Queen of England acknowledged his contribution to rugby. He was so good, a book was written about him entitled Super Sid. A mission instead of a place on the New Zealand All Blacks team? Sid responded, "The blessing of bringing others into the gospel far outweighs anything you will ever sacrifice." One of the great miracles of missionary service in this church is that Sid Going and thousands just like him have not asked, "What will I get from my mission?" but rather, "What can I give?" The priesthood of God has been restored to the earth, and the Lord has set his hand to prepare the world for his glorious return. These are days of great opportunity and important responsibilities. These are your days.